Fried Zakaria GPS. You know, Germany is one of the most important relationships the U.S. has, along with Great Britain. Both those relationships today are under strain, I guess you would say.
You know, and there are two elements to it, I think. One is that Trump is almost pathologically impulsive. Everything he does is just spasmodic. It's spur of the moment. It's emotional. He praises Merkel to the skies when she's up. He kicks her when she's down. You know, it's a momentum play, as it were. Part of it, though, is that Trump really doesn't get the Atlantic Alliance. Ever since he was a real estate developer in the 1980s, he has been on this kick that NATO is useless. All these allies should pay their way. He doesn't understand the achievement of these European countries that after 400 years of warfare have come together. He doesn't understand how important America was in creating that peaceful, prosperous Europe. So that piece of it, you can feel the kind of philosophical gap between Merkel and him. Merkel, when he got elected, she did say something nice, as Tom pointed out. But she finished that statement by saying, but our partnership rests on shared values alone, meaning if you don't share our values, then, you know, there's no point to having an alliance with the United States. So I think that we're in an odd situation today, Anderson, where the Chancellor of Germany has become the leader of the Western liberal yeah. order.
It's also interesting. I mean, there are opinions on letting immigrants coming into the country, whether they're migrants or refugees. Germany's let in as many as 1 million people, as we were talking about before, you know, many of them from Syria, from war-torn areas, many of them without vetting. I mean, they're people who, very cursory vetting at best.
Almost none, as far as we can tell, with anything like the vetting. I mean, American refugees, people need to understand.
2 years.
2 years, 15 American government agencies, biometric IDs.
Right.
The Germans just let these people in. And one has to say, who knows, you know, things can go wrong, but so far, what is striking is how few problems Germany has had.
Relative to 1 million people.
To say is sort of negative stuff about it. Merkel was trying to deal with a catastrophe on her borders, which is these people were pouring in.
Right. These are the relationships, though, which are supposed to be easy. I mean, you wonder, okay, this is happening with these countries who are our allies. What's going to happen with some of these other countries?
Well, you could see the problem with the Chinese, with Trump's relationship with China, where again he began with this impulsive move
right.
that he took a call from the leader of Taiwan and he said, maybe I'll upgrade relations with Taiwan. And I said on this program, actually, if there's a strategy here, fine, that's a useful leverage. But of course, there was no strategy. It was impulse. And the Chinese president said, I'm freezing all contact with the United States until Trump essentially apologizes and reverses himself. Mm. And Trump had to. Trump had to call Xi Jinping, essentially reverse himself. It strikes me as a pretty humiliating cave. But why? Because the original move had never been thought through. And what I worry about is, in a number of these cases, accusing the British government on spying on you. Has anyone thought this through? Has anyone thought about the next time we need the cooperation of the British government? You know, the British government's response is in some ways more striking. The British government said of an official White House statement about that, they said this is ridiculous, it's nonsense, pay no attention to it.
Yeah.
I can't remember the last time the British government has said that about a White House, you know, position.
It's extraordinary. Fried Zakaria, thanks very much. A lot to look for in the days ahead. Just ahead, Republican leaders have set a date to vote on their bill to replace Obamacare. They have 6 more days to lock down votes in the House. What they're doing to win over Republicans who are still holding out.